charity. Hi. Hey, guys, we're the Graham. We're here. Sorry, we took your mic over here. That's why. No, just leave it there. Use the other one. Don't touch this one. It's just for the guitar. My name's Sean Dengler, and that's...
What's up? What's up? What's up?
That's not his name. Mohamed Yual.
What's up?
Right there. And we're here.
Yeah. Can you guys guess what the theme for this show is? There you go.
Exactly. I have no idea who this is, what this is.
Can anybody guess? Anybody? You don't count. Anybody? Nobody knows who this is? Man. Wow, I'm going home, man. This is...
I think Muhammad thinks more people watch anime than what really people watch
anime. It's really popular.
Not here.
All right, fuck. fuck the theme, man. Fuck it.
What?
Fuck it, man.
Pokemon, right? That's the closest thing to anime I get to. Pokemon!
Who has not been to the show before? Raise your hand.
All right.
Go to Instagram.
Go to Instagram.
Instagram app. Oh, shit.
Is it not working?
Forget it. Go to the search bar. Type in the Graham Comedy Show. All lowercase. And follow the show, please. I got a story. I have a story.
There it is.
Do you guys know who Ed Wilson is? The weather? You guys know his?
Ed motherfucking Wilson.
So I did a show with him. He was hosting. And we DM'd Keith Murphy. You guys know who Keith Murphy is?
Yeah.
All right. So we DM'd him asking him to be a guest judge on the show. And he said no. He was busy. But I met Ed Wilson. I have his phone number. I told him, like, can you talk to Keith Murphy, please? And he's like, sure.
Our goal is to get Keith Murphy on this show. That is our goal.
Yes.
Who? We will try to get Ed Wilson too. They're pretty popular guys here, you know, in Des Moines. But
that's the show.
Okay.
Yes.
What else do we got?
Calendars.
Calendars. If you need a 2020, we got 2020 Graham calendars. I did not bring one with me tonight. If you just like to see men with their shirts off, showing their nips, it's the calendar you're looking at. Me and him. He looks in shape. I do not look in shape. Sadly. Looks much more in shape than I do. I'm trying, guys. That's my 2020 resolution. I'm gonna have those abs.
That lady shaking her head. This is the show.
This is a show. We just take our shirts off and we fucking party. That's what we do. It'll be a little better. Trust me.
All right. So we have a judge and
guest judge, performer.
All right. You got him.
What's his last name? I don't know his last name.
Schrag.
Okay. Fancy. All right. So he is a performer. Is he from Ames?
Yes.
He's from Ames. He booked you to do a library show up in Ames?
Yes. I'm going to tell jokes out of library.
It's going to be great. All right. But let's give it up for what? Okay. Let's give it up for Ben Schrag.
Yes.
Hi.
Don't look at my butt.
Hi, my name is Ben Schrag, and I drove down from Ames, Iowa, to be here with you. Hi. I want to start off with a beautiful song that I wrote. Sometimes songs come to you when you find something special and wonderful and important. And that's what happened. I was somewhere in there is my very dear friend and coworker, Tanvi Rastogi. Are you back there? Yeah. Anyway, she gave me a picture of a book, and it changed my life. Can we pull that up? There it is. Yeah, human. So this was in a book the library was going to throw away. And Tanvi was like, this needs to be turned into a poem or a song because it's so amazingly creepy. So we did that, and Tanvi sent me texts and messages that needed to be in the song. And the song's called Human Cat.
I don't know if you can see, but the eyes are really like human-like and creepy.
So here it goes. This is a collaboration. One time, Human Cat saw a guy pay full price for a box of cereal when the same box was half price at the bodega down the street. Yeah. One time, Human Cat saw a guy eat a banana, drop the peel into the purse of the woman walking by. Yeah. These memories haunted Human Cat because he could not warn the unsuspecting victims. He could just meow. And it's a hard life. It's a hard life for Human Cat.
You're gonna have to sing along with that in a little bit, just be warned.
It's a hard life. It's a hard life for Human cats.
Ready for the next one?
One time, Human Cat saw someone replace the office decaf coffee with full calf.
Full calf.
One time, Human Cat saw someone return used underwear to the department store. Human Cat's seen some shit in life, but he can't tell anyone about it. No, he can just meow. And it's a hard life. It's a hard life for Human Cat.
That's your part. Ready? You can do it. Yeah.
It's a hard life. It's a hard life for Human Cat.
Let's try it one more time since we got you there. Let's do it again.
It's a hard life. It's a hard life for Human Cat.
Good, good. Okay, finish strong.
It's a hard life. It's a hard life for Human Cat.
All right, next slide.
Thankfully, Human Cat has seen some nice things too, like the person who bakes tiny cakes for the neighborhood mice.
Yeah.
Human Cat doesn't eat mice, though his favorite food is veggie burritos with extra guac. You shouldn't judge Human Cat by his definitely unsettling appearance, which can kind of freak some people out. And it's a hard life. It's a hard life for Human Cat.
Good, that's good. A little more.
It's a hard life. It's a hard life for Human Cat.
All right.
It's a hard life. It's a hard life for Human Cat. It's a hard life. It's a hard life for Human Cat.
Good job.
Now give it up for Ben Schrag.
Seemed pretty cool.
In the middle.
Yeah, you get the middle spot there.
Hey, I like Ben, guys. He's really cool, guys. He is. I've known him for a long time.
I don't know where I'm putting this mic stand.
Alright, so our first contestant is from Omaha. He drove from Omaha, guys. Can you guys
Clap
for him? Derek Pavelka.
There you go. You got it.
You got it?
No! No! You came through the middle.
It's okay.
We didn't expect it. You've never been here. It's not his fault.
That is the first time that's ever happened. Did someone to walk through the middle of our screen. First time. We'll fix that. Don't worry. All right. Our next contestant, he's been doing comedy a little while here in Des Moines. But let's give it up for Josiah Sutton. There you go. He's got it. He's got it. All right, Mohamed.
Our next is a woman.
Whoa!
It's a girl. She won the show before, guys. Mallory Schafer, guys.
Yeah, give it up for Mallory Schafer. All right. Our next contestant, he's also a fellow comedian, but let's give it up for Elvir Hotic.
Hotic.
Sorry, I butchered his name. No matter what. That's all right. And our last comedian, she is very funny. She ran door for us last month. That's a thing. Let's give it up for Amanda Campbell. All right, so this is how, for those who haven't been here, this is how the show is going to work. We're going to play five Instagram-based rounds. And at the end of the round, we're going to come to you guys, and you're going to help us decide who's going to win each round. You'll get a few points. We will also be grading them on a 0 through 10 scale. That's basically it. Our first round is the caption round. And if you guys don't know what the caption round is, nice-looking food you got there, Dustin. And the caption round is we're going to throw up a picture and a video, and our contestants will write what their caption to that picture or video will be. Sound good, guys? Yeah. Yeah, let's fucking do this thing. Let's get going.
All right, so this is the first video, guys.
What? Those are really big bullet holes. What?
So this is a scene from a Nigerian movie, and Nigerian movies are fucking awful.
It's like filmed in the basement of someone's like house. Really gross looking. This is my favorite part.
This is giving me flashbacks to middle school health class.
Why?
The CGI is just remarkable.
But if it did teach me about human reproduction, that'd be great.
Endgame had shit on this. All right. You guys ready? All right. Lights. Elver, lead us off. Yep. Go up to the mic, and then you can read it.
I was going to say the new Bad Boys movie looks lit.
I'm excited for that Bad Boys movie. 7.5.
I wasn't wild about the preview. I'm giving it a 6.
A good start, man. 7.5.
All right, Derek.
Quentin Tarantino really has a low budget now.
Very true. 7.5.
I'd buy that with an 8. You get more if there was more of a hip soundtrack.
Very conservative. 7.5. Are you writing in cursive?
Yeah. What?
You guys should see.
Oh, sorry, wow. Sorry. I'm going down to 7.
7? Ooh.
That's amazing, man.
All right, Mallory. Sorry.
You said this is the movie version of that Area 51 video game at all of your movie theaters.
Oh! I was too scared of that game. I'll give you an 8, though, because it was everywhere.
I'm also going 8 because I do think they did a Naruto run in there somewhere.
Didn't they? See, he knows. He knows about it. Yeah, man. These guys are doing well. 7.5.
7.5. All right. Josiah.
In the writer's room, what if we had The Matrix but with a water slide?
This is a real shitty Matrix movie. 7.5.
Oh, man. I'm going 7.5 because I want a water slide Matrix.
That sounds terrible. 7.5.
All right, Amanda.
So I said The Matrix would never, hashtag set Keanu, hashtag best movie ever.
Wait, what was that?
The Matrix would never, hashtag set Keanu, hashtag best movie ever.
That took me too long to grasp. 6.
5, because how dare you make Keanu sad?
Yeah, usually someone goes off the rails at this point. 7. 7.
All right. Next caption.
Yes. And did you guys follow the show? Please follow the show, goddammit.
Seriously, follow it. I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb. All right. Yeah. I get those goosebumps every time. I need the hype. Give it up for that guy. That guy's fucking amazing. Yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time. I need the hype.
Dude, he ran a 49.49.400. That's so fast. It's way too dumb, yeah.
I get those goosebumps every time. I was never in that position during traffic. I was always well behind people. I get those goosebumps every time. I need the hype. Dropping that beat. I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah.
I get those goosebumps every time. That's fucking I need hilarious. The hype.
I'm way too, you know, if you pause that like a second and a half before the ending, it'd be looking, it looks so amazing. Just right there, yeah. Just done. That's a better ending for everyone.
Just soaring. It is amazing. Flying.
Can you guys DM Keith Murphy, please? I'm serious. We need to get him on the show.
We want Keith.
Ed Wilson.
Then we'll have him sign this.
Oh, yeah. That'd be-
Can he Skype in?
Skype.
Aaron Kiernan? Okay.
Oh, yeah, she is. Ed Wilson told me. She's short. She's like 5'5" or something like that.
Not that That's short for a woman. All right, you guys ready? Eh? All right. Mallory.
This is an odd casting call for the Nigerian Matrix 2.
All right. Solid callback already. 8.5.
The world needs Nigerian Matrix 2. 9.
God damn it, man. 8.5. That's good. Good callback.
All right, Amanda.
Superman at a track meet, losing.
Oh. That made me sad. I'm gonna have to give you a 7 because I don't like being sad.
I'm giving a 7 because Superman sad makes me happy.
6.5 for sadness.
6.5 for sadness. Woo,
that's cheerable.
Yeah,
yes.
Give it up for sadness.
Sadness deserves a 6.5.
All right, Josiah.
Could round up, but don't have the energy.
This sucks. So is jumping the reason Africans are faster at running?
All right, little too racy for me. 5.5. Too far for me. Let's see what Muhammad does, though. That's the tell. White guilt, baby.
4.5, because I feel like math was somehow involved there. I'm not sure.
All right, Muhammad, resident black man.
This is the point where the show goes off the rails. 10! 10! He went for it.
Yep. Elvir. Jesus.
I don't want to fall on Josiah after that one. This is what happens when you refuse to lose to the white guy.
See, not as racy. 8.5. I like it.
It had chutzpah. 10.
Chutzpah? Wow. Wow. 9.5, man. 9.5.
I don't want to brag, but my score is higher.
All right, Derek, your turn.
He jumped higher and ran faster than a white man in 1 second, just fulfilling the stereotype.
Ooh.
Come on, guys.
I'm gonna be consistent with the racism. 10, 10, 10. 10.
0.5.
I'll give you a 3. 0.5. So a half.
Hey, he worked for that half.
Yeah. All right. What's this?
That's right. Oh, so they're only five boys. Mary's born child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day.
All right, festive, I like it.
Angels, hey. Then you can go on board.
I have no idea what's going on.
So they're only five.
Guys, be careful what you write. Unless it's for Muhammad, he'll give you a 10. Legit doesn't care. So. Yeah. Clear.
Angels, hey. Then you can go on board. To the best right. So they're only.
All right, you guys good? I'm good.
Mary's born child, Jesus
All right.
Christ, was
Lights.
Born on Christmas.
So I put a screenshot of this video on our page. So you guys go caption the video so you guys get win a free ticket to our next show.
Good luck.
Please.
All right, Amanda.
When you thought that was good kush, but it turned out to be meth.
I full-heartedly agree. 10.
10, because meth is always better than math. Right?
Yeah. 10 for meth.
10 for meth. Meth is good on our show.
Is there like, it should confetti come down if there's 3 tens? I don't know. Is this like?
Oh, yeah. All tens?
We don't have the budget.
Quick, stretch your napkins.
I wish we did. Josiah.
This sucks. Shit, did Chance the Rapper lose some teeth?
All right. Don't undermine yourself before you go up. 5. Well, that's your problem.
I'm going 7, and here's why. Because I like the way you turned it around so the audience could read it, which compliments our literateness. Thank you.
Yeah, I should have went for it, man. 6.5.
All right, Derek.
Drugs are a hell of a drug.
I'm sorry, man. You just go up after everyone else who took the punchline, kind of. So I'll give you a 7, though, because it wasn't racist. So cool.
8. Drugs are a hell of a drug.
6.5. It should have been racist.
Jesus. All right, Elvir. Oh, no.
This is Kanye West's Jesus World Tour.
Okay, fun fact, I don't like Kanye. 8.5.
A 7 for Kanye.
Kanye is on the fence. 8.5.
All right, Mallory.
All he want for Christmas is 2 front teeth.
Now that's festive. 9.5.
Oh, it's me.
Yeah, your turn.
8, because 8.
very, very timely Christmas. You guys have a good Christmas? All right. Yes? All right. 9.9 for nice. Being relatable.
Oh! All right, so we're looking at captions?
Yes.
For that one, or is it just that one? All right. What do we got?
I want him to sing a duet with the snake that lives in the side of his head.
Whoa.
Last second track jumpers, where are they now?
He did. If you remember that video, he did land face first.
Yeah.
Which is hard.
Knocked his teeth out.
Because there's, anyway.
Full circle. God damn it, man. Is it Levi?
I think it's Levi.
All right.
You did pretty good. Next time, Levi.
That's good. All right, that's the end of the round.
All right, audience, who do you guys think won that caption round? Just clap for whoever or make noise, whatever, for whoever you think. Do you think it was Derek?
No.
Wow. I'm sorry. That is the first time someone yelled no from the crowd. Sorry. Josiah. Okay, a little bit.
Modest applause.
Elvir. Amanda. Or Mallory. Okay. We got it. all right. So after the first round, the scores are: in fifth place is Derek with 57, and fourth is Josiah with 61, and third is Amanda with 68.5, and second is Elvira with 73.5, and in first is Mallory with 81 points. All right, Mohamed, what's the next round?
All right, so the next round is a new round. We've never played it before.
Yeah, we're here. Special
so
night.
So we asked them to make a commercial about number two pencils. And we told them it has to be 60 seconds, and we're going to see what happens.
We're going to see what happens.
All right, so this is Amanda's commercial.
Do you hate having to use highlighters when you're trying to just write something simple? Me too.
What?
Hey, that a Jason crayon stated? Might work. No, stupid piece of junk. Mechanical pencil. All right. No lead. Screw it. Time for the trusty old number two. Never breaks. Never lets me down. Not like those silly, stupid crayons or those stupid highlighters. And they're a fun way to scare your friends. Pick your nose.
Ew.
Or pick your ears. Just like this crazy person.
What?
Number two pencils. Great way to save the day. Do you hate having to...
Alright, so if you guys can vote on these commercials, go on our story, and there's a picture of Amanda. All you have to do is, if you think she has a good commercial, just vote for her. This is Mallory.
Hi guys, it's Mallory. It's Friday. Thanks for watching my journal. I'm about to start this test. You can see it's a bubble sheet, so I'm going to need a number two pencil. Oh my gosh, where are all my number two pencils?
You got a lot of stuff.
Well, I found my number two pencil. I should have known. Number two pencils. They are the shit. They can write great signs to your boss, like this one. And they have cool accessories like this. Woo! Now, back to this test.
Nice, you're gonna get 25% of them.
There's no way that could be C.
Or 20%.
Good thing it erases. Well, that's it for my video today. Don't forget to go out and buy my favorite product, Ticonderoga, the world's best number two pencil. You can put them to the... Hi, guys.
Wow. That was good. All right. That is... So all of theirs are on our Instagram or whatever.
There's a photo of them in our story, okay, if you like
number
it.
Number two
the
pencil.
Audience votes on
you know
it.
You love it. It's an American classic. It's how we won the war in Vietnam. You think this is just for writing? You're an idiot. You could use it as a toothpick. You could use it for firewood. Sharpen it, you have a shiv. I've robbed at least 10 liquor stores in the Des Moines area. Every number two pencil comes with a handy eraser. Undo your mistakes. That bad grade you got in that class you never studied for. That time you got really drunk at a party and called your ex. The time you were driving and you hit something kind of large and you're pretty sure it was a kid, but you didn't turn back. You just kept going.
Oofda.
It can also be a funny mustache. Purchase your number 2 pencil at a Walmart near you. A company officially endorsed by the Gram. The Gram also endorses Chick-fil-A, Amazon, and that algorithm t-shirt company that got in trouble for making a shirt that said, "I like to kill Jews." Thank you for coming to the Gram, officially sponsored by Fox News, Breitbart, and that weird uncle that won't shut up about immigrants. Number 2 pencil.
God damn
it.
Sean, he got my vote. He mentioned Chick-fil-A. God damn it.
Gross. Didn't get mine. There it is.
I'm Dr. Richard Dixon. I'm the president of Number 2 Pencils International and the co-founder of the European and American team for accurate size standards. Technology has been great, but unfortunately with technology, some groups have been marginalized. One group of people that's been extremely marginalized because of technology have been the people who have long, skinny genitals, also known as pencil dicks. It's very frequent that the eggplant emoji is used to inconspicuously sext. But that's not accurate for everybody. Some people have pencil dicks. And using the eggplant emoji is inherently shaming people with these pencil dicks. I'm pledging $100 to Pencil Dick Awareness for every one pack of Number 2 pencils that is purchased. We will raise the frequency of the use of the pencil dick emoji when it comes to sexting. We want people to be happy, and we want men to be confident in what their sizes truly are.
I have.
We have pencil dicks. I'm Dr. Richard. I'm the president of...
Nice.
Somewhere Tom Cruise started movie running... all the way to Des Moines. Tom Cruise is a better runner because his dick is so small. There's less friction.
What are you doing? You made a whole new instant.
Look, I have prefaces before this. Mine is actually 1:20.
Uh-oh. Humble brag.
Oh, hey. Today, on this infomercial, we're going to be talking to you guys about Number 2 pencils. The only time the number 2 actually means number 1. Here we have the case of Number 2 pencils. I'm going to explain to you guys the first benefit of Number 2 pencils. Number 1, indestructible. What do you have to look for? Instructable. You've heard of mechanical pencils, and you've also heard of mechanical issues. Coincidence? I don't think so. I know what you're thinking. I like to be high. These are the wrong kind of high. You start snorting. Do you really want to be known as a coked out, yellow-nosed Rudolph? Oh, hey.
Oh,
finally, a pen. Ink all over my hands like I just jerked off. No thank you. But you don't have to take my word for it. Let's consult the medical professional. They're good. I have the hat, the same hat on. Cut it. There you have it. Go to the back.
There you have it.
Nice.
That answers a lot of my questions.
All right, so guys, please go vote for your favorite commercial. And it's for time for the third round.
All right.
Third round.
It's your it's your favorite round, isn't it?
It's your favorite round. Anybody guess what the third round is? All right, hood fights. All right, so we're going to watch hood fights, and they're going to explain why the fight started. So pick somebody at random, Sean.
We'll do Amanda. This guy seems very small. Will there be a fight? Wait, he just pulled his shorts up? What? Wait, that was it? They're just circling each other? I just like the guy in the red shirt pulls his shorts up, you know.
It's very anticlimactic.
And pulls him up. Oh, yeah. Gary kicked me in the groin now.
That's a lot of thighs.
You know, Amanda, why this hood fight maybe not really started, but kind of, I guess. It's a nice apartment complex parking lot.
So the dude in the red shirt is mad because the other dude, his older brother, ran over the basketball with the Ford Taurus.
Okay.
And trying to show a display of dominance, you know, hiking them shorts up. The other dude just can't hang.
I unfortunately have never showed dominance by hiking my shorts up, so I'll give you a 7.
I'm going to give you a 6 because I once owned a Ford Taurus.
Me too!
Me too. Me too! They rust out in the most peculiar way.
Yeah. Garbage. Crap. Yeah, I'm sorry. I picked that. That was very... That was not good. 8. That was my fault.
All right.
I picked someone.
All right, Elvir.
Come on, Chris. Let's go. This nigga can't fuck with me,
on, nigga. Come on, what's
nigga
up?
California made me.
What's up?
Let's go, Chris.
Terrible cameraman. Yes.
Get the fuck out of here.
It's multiple. It's multiple fights.
How is he going to answer that? There's 3 fights.
See, it goes back to the original.
Come on, Chris. Let's go. This nigga can't fuck with me,
on, nigga. Come on, what's up?
Nigga, California made me.
What's up?
Let's go, Chris.
Get the fuck out of here.
You're at the pussy.
All right. Go with that?
Yeah, sure.
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 All right. I'll give you 7 still. Because Muhammad, I don't know why you're giving 3 fights to one person and
no,
0 fights no, to another person.
This is like 5 fights, and I think that's worth 2 points apiece.
Jesus.
Math.
I try not to pick a violent... You guys know how hard it is not to pick a violent fight? All right. 8. I try.
No, I don't think it's that hard.
It's really hard.
All right. Derek, you take this one.
Oh, yes.
Okay, that... No.
Come on, I like this.
Oh. Okay. Get it after this. We're only watching this.
Yeah.
I like, he doesn't even, look.
Come on, I like that.
I like his shorts out. All right. Derek, you ready?
Merry Christmas.
Why'd this fight start? Poor guy in the real
So this fight started because man number one, I'll call him Dave. Dave took Tayshawn's capris, and Tayshawn wasn't too happy about it, and so they ended up starting a fight over it. That's why that's occurring.
All right. Deshaun, Dave, I'm pretty sure I know who's who by your names.
Oh, don't be white and weird about it.
I am 5.
3.5.
3.5.
7 for logic.
All right. Mallory, you take this one. He drops him. Pretty good. Why am I doing Larry David? All right, you ready, Mallory? One more time. All right. Watch me get dropped. Oh my God. Okay. Why did this guy get fucking dropped? Say that into the mic. I'll. Why did this guy get dropped?
He took his 2 front teeth.
All right, that's fair.
That's true.
Fair enough. His 2 front teeth, 8.
Yeah. 8 for the Christmas throwback.
Christmas throwback, that was fun, right? his hat flew back. Seven. See, that wasn't. There's a dark side of Instagram, guys. You have no idea.
All right, Josiah.
I'll let you hit me.
What's that?
I'll let you hit me. Some dumb shit. I'll let you hit me.
This guy's fucking trying to look swole.
Okay.
Guess what? He isn't.
I'll let you hit me. Boy.
What? What? That guy's my favorite part.
Really? Push me. Something.
Oh my god. Oh. This is going on way longer than I thought it would last. Where was the guy who popped into frame? Why isn't he helping?
Come on, nigga.
Get him, Kevon.
Come on. Let's go.
Kevon, get him.
Get him.
Y'all chill.
Get him. Get him, nigga. Come on.
Say it, Edward.
Let's go.
Wow.
Get your ass up.
I don't know. Maybe that one caption says that he said the N-word. Little sweet ah white boy. It's the first caption up there.
I'll let you hit me.
Shout out to the ponytail.
Okay. Who is the ponytail? I'll
let you hit me. Right there.
Boy. That guy is my favorite guy. I want to know where he is at right now. The fact he's like at this hood fight and he's like, what up? I'm gonna wave in front of this and not help a damn person out.
Ooh.
And then this just happens.
I like that this is in the suburbs.
Definitely in the suburbs.
I like to imagine there's like a parenting meetup, like just off screen. Preschoolers.
As a potluck.
Let's go.
Probably a potluck for a cross country or something. All right, Josiah, you know why this fight started at this country club?
They're trying to recreate that scene from Fight Club. Like, oh man, hit me, hit me.
Josiah. Yeah, something. There's only one rule about Fight Club.
Oh.
So for that, I'll give you a six. We'll talk about Fight Club.
Yeah. Also a six for Fight Club because Brad Pitt was pretty good.
Hey.
Yeah.
Yeah. Solid Fight Club reference. Seven. The next two fights I do, I'll try to get be all white.
Oh, yeah, give her a fight next time. Audience, who do you guys think won the hood fight round? Unfortunately, Amanda, you probably did.
I know who lost.
Who lost? We all lost.
America, yeah.
Who do you guys think won the hood fight round? Do you think it was Derek? If you can remember, I can't. Josiah. Yeah, that's okay. Elvir. Amanda. Mallory. Ooh, Derek or Mallory? All right, let's give it for Mallory. Derek. All right, it's Derek. That made it simple after that round. Score update is here we go. In fifth place is Derek with 77.5. In fourth is Josiah with 80. In third is Amanda with 89.5. In second is Elvira with 98.5. And in first is Mallory with 104. All right, and we're on to our next round.
Florida news. All right, so we're going to read this headline, and they're going to have to come up with the next crime of the criminal in the headline. So a Florida man arrested for passing out marijuana because it was Christmas.
What's the problem?
What's his next crime? Is that? I thought that was good. I thought it was legal.
Not everywhere.
Not in Florida?
Probably not in Florida. There's too many old people down there. Yeah, exactly. They should be all for it. I'm trying to think of some Christmas marijuana pun, but I can't think of it. Merry Smokemas? Merry
Smokemas? Evergreen? I don't know.
What Christmas song? I'm trying to think of a Christmas song.
The weather outside is frightful, so let's stay inside and do drugs. Right?
What Rudolph, the fuck is going on?
The red-eyed reindeer. Oh, there you go. Oh. That's good.
Yeah.
That is good.
Yeah. Religious, too.
Oh, holy night.
Yeah, yeah.
We all are getting higher. Yeah. That's uh-huh. not it. Okay. You guys ready? You got your crimes? How about Amanda, you lead us off. Lights. Love it.
After testing, figured out it was meth, but not the good stuff.
What good meth is there? I'll give you a 7. 7. I can't find it. 7. 6.
Did I say 8 for meth earlier?
I think so.
8 for meth.
8 for meth.
Ooh. That's
all right, just out there.
You're consistent.
Florida man opens Christmas. It's not weed, I promise. Bakery.
All right. I will give you 7.5 for that.
I promise.
Yeah, I 7 because I like any bakery that has to say I promise in the title.
Yes, what Ben said. Yeah, 7.
7?
7.
7.
7. They're cookies, I promise.
That's great.
All right, Mallory.
I said he got arrested for takesies backsies. He looks like he's never passed on some weed a day in his life.
He does look pretty good.
True fact. 8.
Yeah, 8.5 because that's some sweet hair there. Yeah.
Taking back backsies.
Actually, from where I'm sitting, never mind.
I like that phrase. 8.
8. All right, Derek.
Florida man got arrested again after this for pimping out little people on St. Patrick's Day.
Those poor little people. 9.
Yeah. I'm going 9 as well. Would have been a 10, except for I think that could have actually happened, and it scares me.
That sounds fun. 9.5.
All right, Josiah.
Florida man arrested for being a really cool communist, like handing out rounds.
Really cool what?
Communist.
Fuck communism. 9. Wait, why did I give you a 9? Whatever, I said it. It's there. You locked out because I...
I'm going with 8 because, again, the haircut, cool.
8 for me as well. Shout out to communism.
I'm not a supporter of communism, but my brain farted and I gave him a 9.
I think communists would support that.
I do.
That is true. I think the funniest thing that's happening up here you're all missing, which is us desperately trying with our left hands to like pull up a number, any number.
That
makes too much sense.
All right, next Florida crime.
Florida man allegedly masturbated onto a woman in a toy aisle at Walmart.
How does allegedly fit in that?
Yeah, that's true. Alleged. I think you know or you don't know it happened.
He got nice eyebrows.
That's a weird thing to take away from us. Very weird. Oh my God. Nice! Lonely Island, I like that part at least.
He looks pretty relaxed.
Indeed he does. This really never happens, you can take my word. I won't apologize, that's just absurd. Mainly your fault for the way that you dance. And now I jizz in my pants. Don't tell your friends or I'll say you're a slut. Plus it's your fault. Great song, guys. I'm very
sensitive. Also, like,
jizz in my pants. I'll go
home and either, I know, like, she couldn't have been that short, right? Like,
what? What does that matter? Alright, I don't want to know. Lights. Derek, lead us off. What did this guy do after this?
Florida man was arrested again after breaking into Louis C.K.'s hotel room and jerking off in front of him.
All right, fair. 10.
Yeah, I'm shocked that hasn't happened yet. 10.
Very comedian-friendly reference there. 10, 10.
All right,
that's good.
Josiah.
Florida man also allegedly got it on a bionicle.
Wait, what? I was bionicle?
It's a toy.
I don't know what the fuck toy that is, so I'm going to give you a 6. I don't know what the hell that is. I was a freshman in high school.
Yeah, I was going to say, oh my God, you're getting a 5 because I'm 42 years old.
Wow. Okay, so he got some semen on the toy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Wow. Way to class this up.
7.5 for semen.
That is disgusting. So gross.
Semen and a half? That's terrible.
Semen and a half. That's good. Amanda.
Florida man went to Lowe's and took a shit in the display toilets.
Yeah. There is nothing wrong with that, I feel like. I'll give you an 8 for that.
I'm going 7 because I think it actually would have been better if you just would have said Florida man went to Lowe's, period. Done.
But that's not
a 5. 7 for logic.
All right, Elvir. Oh, sorry.
I already got it in my head.
Okay.
Florida man forced to pay child support.
He, what? Sorry, I didn't. He should be 10.
Yeah, I'm also a 10, but it's for the kids.
It's fucked up, man. 10 for the children.
Mohamed, I like how you're showing me the number first. This is good. The audience, yeah.
All right, Mallory.
I realize now this is more of like the crime that came before this, but Florida man was arrested for stealing 69 copies of Babes in Toyland.
Ooh. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is that a porn?
It is now.
It is now?
69. Nice, 8.5.
I'm going 9 because unlike George Lucas, you just pulled off the prequel.
Ooh, yeah. Shots fired.
Well.
8.5 for a good porn title.
All right. Next crime.
Florida man accidentally shoots self in leg and leg while playing cowboy, deputies say.
While playing cowboy.
That sounds really defensive from the deputies, right? Like, I think they were involved.
I saw Matthew, and then I thought I was going to see McConaughey below that. Mad McConaughey playing cowboy?
Yeah, I see it.
Yeah. I'm going to be a cowboy. Well, oh, fuck!
Well,
my leg!
As a 42-year-old, I'm old enough to remember when Matthew McConaughey got arrested for playing the bongos naked. Do you remember that?
No, what? Yeah. That happened?
Yeah, that happened. Yeah. All right.
Where did he get... Where did that happen?
I'm assuming in the street.
Just in the street. Was he drunk then?
I think he was pretty high.
Oh,
Oh, well, that makes it okay.
I thought playing the bongos was legal.
I can be naked out here? All right. Sir, we're going to have to take you in. All right.
You can't be naked and play the bongos? What kind of
country are we living in? Yeah. Right, Charity? Naked bongos, the best bongos. Bongos! Bongos is just a fun word to say.
Bongos is a fun word. You know, we need more bongos.
We need more bongos. There was, on my honeymoon, there was a club in the Dominican My wife's in the audience. What was it, like Bongo Wongo Club or something? What do you remember what it's called? Coco Bongo? I don't know. Was it Coco? I don't know. You guys don't care. That's fine. Bongo's in the word. It's fun.
We care about the fact that you're married and you have a wife. We like that.
Thank you. Give it up for my wife for coming out. Feeling a little under the weather. She's the best.
Yes.
All right. You guys ready? Yeah, 10. Absolutely. Actually, no. 100 out of 10.
Oh.
Fair. All right. Lights. Elvir, take us away.
Florida man accidentally shoots himself in the back. I promise, deputies say.
I'll give you a 9.
Also 9, because man, that's a good line. They got to use that more.
I'm going to ruin this whole thing. Black Lives Matter.
What? I think Muhammad's the only one here that got his own joke.
But I will say, yours would also make a good bakery.
Yeah, you know how like black people get shot or whatever? 9.5.
9.5?
Yeah.
Cool. Mallory.
Florida man slices off penis while playing samurai.
Oh!
Deputies say.
Yeah, you gotta finish with deputies say. 8.5.
7.5.
That had logic and it was funny. 8.5.
Yeah. Hey, you're a smart crowd. We're not talking down to you. We know you can logic, and we're rewarding you for it.
All right, Josiah.
Ergo.
Florida man accidentally destroys the city after playing Chernobyl engineer.
I like these history things. 9.
10, that made me feel smart.
Yeah, he works out a plant. That's funny. 9.5.
All right, Derek.
Florida man was arrested again after this for grabbing a woman's booty after pretending to play pirate.
Got a little bit of a groan from the audience, but I like the pun. 8.5.
That had layers to it, man.
All I heard was the pun.
I feel like that's a joke I might have made, so I'm going to say 4.
Oh. Hey, man. You're not that bad.
Wow. Wow.
42 years old. 42 years old. Father of 2.
8.5. The half is for your handwriting. You guys should see his handwriting, guys. It's really nice.
It's beautiful.
All right, Amanda.
Classed it up, I think.
What's this crime?
Florida man was also arrested for shooting his friend with a bow and arrow because he was the Indian.
Is there also a cop and what's? No, I was gonna say a YMCA thing. There's no cowboy in the Village People. I'm dumb. I'm gonna give you a 9.5 for my stupidity of just making that bet. Ah, whatever. I'm done. I've made my call.
I'm saying 5 because you made Muhammad say holy shit, and I think that's worth something.
Damn, that's fucked up, man. Have we gone through all the races? Okay, 8. 8.
All right. Good, the audience.
Did anybody comment on the Florida news thing? No?
Is anyone from Florida?
Okay.
Good. Safe. You ready?
All right. No, nobody commented.
All right, audience, who do you guys think? Who do you think won the Florida news round? Do you think it was Mallory? Amanda? Elvir, golf claps. Josiah. Or Derek. It is Josiah there. I'm going to give that to Josiah. All right, so after that round, the score update is: in fifth place is Amanda with 155, in fourth is Derek with 156, and third is Josiah with 157, in second is Elvira with 177.5, and in first is Mallory with 179. Close, guys, for a couple of you.
All right, so fifth round is the last round, so they're going to go somewhere in the area, they're going to take a selfie. And they're going to come back, and then we're going to judge it. While they're doing that, Ben is going to perform his last song for you guys. So give it up for Ben, guys.
Okay. What's my, which mic?
Young man, there's no way to feel down. I said, young man, pick yourself up the ground. I said, young man.
Okay. Well, this has been so much fun. I think we've learned a lot about each other in America. And how horrible it feels to watch people fighting each other. Oh, no. Try that. Yes? Stay put. All right, well, I'm going to play this song. This is I play in a band called Ben Schrag and the Cautionaries. We're based out of Ames, and we occasionally play music. This is a tune we play.
I don't really know what we're doing. Gotta take it slow, gotta take it slow, gotta take it slow. Slow with you, yeah. You don't really want something that's broken to mend. I don't really want to leave myself open again. I don't really want to hear you say something I don't want, no. Oh, oh, oh. Because oh, 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 here we go again. I don't really know what we do, but we're getting closer to it. You don't really want something that's broken to mend. I don't really want to leave myself open again. I don't really want to hear you say something I don't want to know. Whoa. Because I don't really know what we do, but we're getting closer to it. You don't really want something that's broken to mend. I don't really want to leave myself open again. I don't really want to hear you say something I don't know. Here we go again. Open eyes and innocent. Oh, here we go again. Open eyes.
is unfair.
All right. Yeah.
Shout out to Ben, guys.
Yeah, give it up for Ben.
Great judge.
Give it up for Ben.
Great judge.
Good for Ben. Great judge. We got two of our contestants back. This is where we just go, God damn it, why aren't they back yet? I don't know.
I apologize for the Black Lives Matter comments.
You guys, I don't know why you're apologizing. I think more people were like, I don't know what you're talking about.
No, like,
what's the reference?
I was sitting here thinking, you're handsome.
No, because, you know, he got shot because he was, the police shot him because he's white. I just, that's what I...
No, please explain it more.
Yes, just explain this more. Confused us all. Mallory!
Mallory!
Didn't work. That's fine. That's okay.
It's better be a good picture.
Our next show is January 24th, FYI. Same place, same time. Hey, look at that! We're good. All right. Selfie round. Let's see who has the best selfie.
Where's your photo? Is it in your personal page?
No, hold up,
a poster. Okay. Never mind.
Oh, I just got an update. My wife said the place that I was trying to reference in the Dominican, the club is called Coco Bongo.
Do I get points for that?
Yeah, you should, but you're not. Okay. All right, here we go. The man I coerced into saying he has a pencil dick for the advertisement that I ran back to see for this.
That's funny. Hey, is he your friend?
No, I just met him today.
Oh, wow. Okay, 8.5.
Stranger danger, 9, though.
8.5 because friends for life, no.
Yeah. All right.
Are you vaping?
Oh, not cool, man.
Wow.
All right. What's the caption? Vaping in the boys' room.
Also, the guy in the second picture gave me a second beer when I bought one, and I just wanted to shout him out and tell everyone he rocks.
This is
very
cool.
Hey, that's...
Is he going to give everyone a second beer now? Is this...
we know that guy.
That's DK.
Yeah, he's been on the show. He's awesome. For putting DK on the show, I'll give you 8.5.
Solid 7.
I fucking hate vaping, man. It's like, but then I like that guy.
Conflicted.
8.
Yes.
All right.
That's the first one? Or the second?
Alien head emoji.
Ooh.
Thank you. Are you pandering to me? I'm in an improv group called Alien Head Emoji for anyone. Oh. Know about them?
Yeah.
A real one. Okay.
That one.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, you went to Fong's?
That's quick.
I am very fast.
Damn.
Well, that's goddamn impressive. 9.5.
I'm also going 9.5 because can you go back to the other picture? I want to say that when I parked, the parking meter said, "You are okay." And it made me feel so good. And look right there. I was not looking at the alien. I was looking at the "you are okay." Thank you. I am okay. 9.5.
9.5 for crossing the street. we got a classic.
Ooh. Me and all my friends. Hashtag popular AF. Hashtag party.
This reminds me of 2013.
Why?
It just seems like the time era.
It's a weird observation. 8.5.
9 because I want to be popular too.
9 for the classic selfie.
All right. Now one more.
Who's left?
Elvir.
Hey, shout out to the audience, man. You guys have been amazing. Woo! Shout out to the audience. I hate to get too political, but at the joy on my face is acceptance of this challenge. Hashtag Trump.
I do not. Six.
0.5.
God damn. You know what? I hate Trump, but it's funny. 7.
Okay. Thank you for that. All right. Audience, who do you guys think won the selfie round? Do you think it was Derek? Then it was Josiah. Then it was Elvir. Just Elvir clapping for himself. Amanda. Or Mallory. Mallory seemed more sustained. All right, so we have gotten the results in for the
commercials you guys watched
round,
earlier. Yes. Mallory got 6 votes.
Okay, that's how many points they're getting, FYI.
Yes. Derek got 7 votes.
Okay.
Shout out to Pencil Penis, Pencil Dick.
Pencil Penis does sound more serious, though.
More alliteration. Pencil Penis. Pencil Penis. Pencil penis.
It does feel good on pencil the tongue,
penis.
Doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. It does. Pencil penis. All right.
I'm sorry. Amanda got 5 votes.
Who?
Amanda.
Amanda got 5. Okay.
And then Josiah got 7 votes.
What Elvira get?
4 votes.
Sorry. All right. So that has concluded all the rounds, audience. So now we are down to decide who the winner is and what are the prizes they all get to get. That's for... What's first place get, I guess, is my question. That's first place. Mohamed makes those. He literally makes those all with his hands. So, here we go. Sorry. In fifth place is Amanda with 186.5 points. And fourth place is with Josiah with 187.5 points. In third is Derek with 189 points. And second is Elvir with 195 points. So our winners, 2-time winner, Mallory with 218.5 points. Speech.
Don't be a pencil dick. Come to the next gram.
Yeah, don't be a pencil dick.
Pencil penis.
All right, guys. That has been the gram.
Yes.
Thank you so much for coming.
Yes.
Anything else?
Yeah. Shout out to Ben.
Yeah, shout out to Ben. Go to their library show. Shout out to our contestants.
Sorry, everybody. Can you guys come to the next show? God damn it. Please.
Yes.
Please.
Yeah, please come to the show. Give it up for our contestants, though. They all did a wonderful job. Give up for Brad for running door. Yeah. Most importantly, MJ in the back running tech for us, making all those music, all that stuff. And also, thank you guys so much for coming out and supporting live comedy here in Des Moines, Iowa. It is our pleasure to come out and perform. So thank you so much. Have a wonderful night. God bless, I guess. I don't know. God bless. It's the season, guys. Whatever. Thank you all for coming out. Thank you.